Hello, everybody, and Happy New Year. My name is Ken Godshall. The scripture passage this week was based on a passage from the Gospel of Luke. Let's begin with Luke chapter 2, verses 41 through 52. Now, every year his parents went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. And when he was 12 years old, they went up as usual for the festival. When the festival was ended and they started to return, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem, but his parents were unaware of this. Assuming that he was in the group of travelers, they went a day's journey. Then they started to look for him among their relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they returned to Jerusalem to search for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. And all who heard him were amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Child, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously looking for you." He said to them, "Why were you searching for me? Did you not know that I must be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he said to them. Then he went down with them and came to Nazareth and was obedient to them, and his mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus increased in wisdom and in years and in divine and human favor. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. When I was in middle school many years ago, I went on a 3-day field trip to Richmond, Virginia. My social studies teacher was a Civil War enthusiast who took interested parent students every year to visit the battlefields where the war was fought. One evening after dinner, my two roommates and I somehow got separated from the group for a few hours. We went back to the hotel, played cards, had a grand old time. When the teacher caught up with us later that evening, he did not raise his voice, but communicated clearly that if we ever did that again, we would be banned from future trips for the rest of our school days. The second scripture lesson this morning is about the visit of Jesus to the temple at age 12. Jesus gets separated from his parents at the end of a Passover trip to Jerusalem. For a parent, losing track of your child for just a few minutes is a traumatic event. How in the world did Mary and Joseph let Jesus go missing for 3 full days? Pilgrimages in ancient Israel were usually undertaken in a large group of family, relative, neighbors, and friends. Traveling at 15 miles a day, the caravan trek to Jerusalem for Passover took 4 days each way. Women and children traveled in one group, followed by the men in another group. Once they began the journey, the two groups would not come together until they met at a prearranged place on the journey home. Only when the parents came together after leaving Jerusalem did they discover that 12-year-old Jesus was with neither parent and needed to be found. Notice that Mary and Joseph are never criticized for losing track of Jesus. The Gospel of Luke emphasizes instead that they were faithful Jewish parents in every way. Jesus was circumcised as a baby in the Hebrew tradition. He was presented at the temple at 8 weeks when his mother was purified. The family makes the annual Passover trip required by the law of Moses. And the Gospel of Luke says 5 different times that the parents of Jesus acted according to the law. Whatever happened with Jesus, it was not their fault. If the story isn't about bad parenting, what is it about? It's about the struggles that Jesus experienced growing up as the son of Mary and Joseph, and at the same time as the Son of God. One of the mysteries of our faith is that Jesus is both human and divine. This dual nature makes it hard to describe the kind of person Jesus was here on earth. In the Gospel of John, for example, Jesus is famously described as the Word of God made flesh, come to dwell among us. That's haunting and poetic and memorable. But what was Jesus really like as a human being before his ministry began? Was Jesus an ordinary person growing up, or was he special right from the beginning? The Bible lesson offers a realistic picture of Jesus' early life. He is not just a heavenly figure, the Son of God. Jesus is also a normal kid who didn't always communicate well. He lived in an imperfect family, had the same parental disagreements that you and I have experienced. Jesus does not come into the world as a fully formed person. He starts out as a boy and then grows in wisdom like the rest of us. The story about a family trip to Jerusalem is notable for its restraint. There are no miracles or prophecies. The narration is matter of fact. Jesus stays behind in Jerusalem, but somehow fails to let his parents know. When the parents do find him in the temple, Jesus does not agree that he did anything wrong, but he obediently agrees to return home with them. It is a classic standoff between a teenager and his parents. Each party is unable to appreciate the other's point of view. The disagreement is not resolved. And all Mary can do is ponder the experience in her heart. When Jesus was found in the temple by his parents, he didn't say, "I looked for you and couldn't find you, so I came here." What Jesus says is, "Why didn't you know that I was in my Father's house?" The mystery surrounding Jesus' miraculous birth has somehow faded within his own family. Mary and Joseph have completely forgotten that their son is the Messiah. That's why it doesn't initially occur to them to look for Jesus in the temple. As parents, it can be hard to watch our children grow up. We're not always ready when it's time for our children to leave home. Luke tells this story to remind us that the adolescent struggles we struggle with today were present in the life of Jesus. Have you ever wondered if Jesus really is the Son of God, why he just didn't tell people what to do and get on with things? If Jesus is God's Son, why doesn't Jesus forgive everyone's sins and spare us the parables and the healings and the crucifixion too? The answer is that during the lifetime of Jesus, the people of Israel were not sure that he was the Messiah, not even his disciples and followers. The people around him struggled with the idea that Jesus was the Son of God and therefore often refused the help that he offered. If the world around him struggled with fully human, fully divine, it should not surprise us that Jesus did too. In the Bible lesson, he is just starting to get some separation from his parents. When he visits the temple, the rabbis are amazed at his understanding and his answers. For the first time, others outside the family are picking up on the special abilities in Jesus that his own parents can't see. The temple visit suggests that Jesus will grow into his new identity as the Son of God, but the realization dawns on Jesus gradually. It does not happen overnight. The scripture passage describes how Jesus grew into his faith, beginning with a trip to the temple in his youth. Are there any practical lessons that you and I can learn from his experience? For starters, we should realize that the religious traditions that we grow up in have lasting value. The Gospel of Luke confirms that the early life of Jesus was rooted in the faith of ancient Israel. The education Jesus received from his parents and the temple rabbis gave him the foundation for his ministry. Jesus challenged the religious leaders of his day from the first day of his ministry to the last. But at no time does Jesus reject Judaism or walk away for something else. Jesus, our Lord and Savior, was a Jew. We would also do well to remember that we have an obligation as Christians to understand and respect the religion of Jesus. His tradition is our tradition too. Think of Judaism as the older brother or sister who helped us when we were young. Because of this relationship, we have a responsibility to vigorously resist anti-Semitism when we experience it in everyday life today. Because of our shared history with the Jewish people, we have an obligation to provide an appropriate but not uncritical support for the modern state of Israel. The relationship of Jesus to Judaism offers another idea as well. If Christianity is our main religious tradition, we should take it seriously as Jesus and his family took Judaism. If you look around today, Christianity appears to be losing traction. The pandemic has accelerated the trend, but the truth is we have been suffering steady membership erosion for decades. My advice for people who grow up in Christianity and are struggling with it is not to abandon the tradition, but to live into it. Take your religious upbringing seriously. Try to be observant. Explore the mysteries of faith and its promises. You will be in a better position to find the spiritual satisfaction that all of us are looking for by doing what Jesus did. Don't reject your tradition or walk away from it. Embrace Christianity so you can learn from it the way Jesus learned from Judaism. To be more specific, if you find yourself getting spiritual encouragement from other sources as you get older, don't throw away your Christian faith, add to it. If you are getting spiritual inspiration and satisfaction from yoga or outdoor hiking or Eastern religions, don't drop Christianity. Use your new interest to build on top of what the Christian tradition provides. Personalize your experience of God by bringing your insights to a tradition of faith that has been useful and productive for more than 2,000 years. Remember that Jesus didn't throw away what was given to him. He built on it, which is the approach that we should try. Is it really possible, as I am claiming, for the Christian church to provide a strong foundation for faith at a time when so many people are leaving? Casimir Byrne is a peace pastor who is a year or two ahead of me in seminary a few years ago. He writes, "The church is the only place today where we can hear and talk about God and faith and hope they are not a caricature as portrayed in the media or a ruse as performed by the politicians. We are the last place in society where grace is a name, is not a name, but a gift. The cross is not a scratched out mistake on a written page, but a symbol of a predestined act of love. Communion is not a noun, but a state of being. And where God is more than a feeling you get when you think of pink, fluffy unicorns dancing on rainbows. The church is the only place where we can talk about God, and more precisely, the God revealed to us in Christ Jesus, his love shown for us, the life that he gave to us." What I like about the scripture lesson this morning is how the Jerusalem temple nourishes the spiritual life of Jesus by providing that kind of support. During the temple visit, no one says to Jesus, "What are you doing here, young fellow?" The teachers take Jesus seriously as a boy and include him in their instruction. Can you say the same about the church that you worship in today? Are there people here who welcomed you to church life when you first arrived? Is this a place you turn to when you want to expand your spiritual boundaries? Did anyone in this church ever say something about one of your children that was insightful and true and that you as a parent missed? Has the church confirmed you in your faith as the boy Jesus was confirmed in the Jerusalem temple? because that's what this church and others are trying to do. One of the blessings in the Bible lesson is that Luke wants us to know that questions are natural to religious faith. Mary and Joseph question Jesus. Jesus questions his teachers and his parents. What's the meaning of all the questions? As one scholar points out, it means that a full understanding of Jesus the Messiah, fully human and fully divine, is complicated and takes time. To grow in the faith, to understand what it's all about, we have to listen and learn as Jesus did. The Bible lesson shows that the church has been open for dialogue and discussion from the beginning. In the scripture story, Jesus is growing up too fast for his parents. But what Luke says is that faith formation grows slowly. It will take another 18 years before Jesus appears again in the Gospel of Luke at the beginning of his ministry. His spiritual formation takes a long time, years and years. What we see is one brief moment at the beginning. To grow in the faith, to grow with Jesus, we need to invest time, exercise patience, and not expect instant answers. The message of this sermon is that we have something to learn from the boy Jesus. Honor the faith that God has given you. Remember that your parents aren't perfect. Ask good questions. Give yourself a little time. Above all, try to avoid getting separated from your family. Let's pray. Dear God, we thank you for the opportunity to grow in faith as Jesus did with the help of our families and the church we love. Amen.